Okay, I think we have already quite a few joining us, so we'll get started. Welcome to the National Alopecia Areata Foundation's webinar, Your Questions Answered, More on Managing the Wig Process and Cosmetic Challenges. Joining us today are Amy Gibson, Kathleen Leonard, and Georgia Van Kallenberg. I'm Judy Williams, Support and Education Director for NAF. I'd like to cover a few housekeeping details. We have disabled chat for this webinar session. If you do have questions for our speakers in the Q&A section, there will be an option there, but as a reminder, this is the second, so we're gonna try to answer as many as possible today from our previous webinar. And this webinar is being recorded and all registrants will receive a link to this recording via email a few days after the program. And finally, please share your feedback with us. At the conclusion of the webinar, a link to a short survey will pop up in your browser window. So make sure to complete the survey there, please. This webinar is part of NAF's You Are Not Alone Education and Empowerment webinar series. We're hosting a diverse group of speakers on a range of topics, and we want this series to meet your needs. We welcome your input on topics that you would like to see covered. NAF gratefully acknowledges the support provided for this series by Eli Lilly and Company. I'd also like to tell you a little bit about NAF and our mission. The National Alopecia Areata Foundation is the leading advocacy organization for alopecia areata and celebrated its 40th anniversary last year. NAF's mission is to support research to find a cure or acceptable treatment for alopecia areata, support those with the disease, and educate the public about alopecia areata. NAF's vision is an empowered community with the choice to embrace or live free of alopecia areata. To learn more about NAF's support resources and research and advocacy activities, or to join us as an advocate or supporter, please visit our website at naf.org. And before we start our webinar, I'd like to tell you a little bit about NAF's annual conference. This is the largest and most complete gathering of the alopecia areata community. We want you to come meet other resilient individuals living with alopecia areata and their families and learn more from experts, including researchers, clinicians, and medical professionals. There's something for all ages at this conference. It will be held in person in Denver, Colorado from Friday, June 30th to Sunday, July 2nd. You won't want to miss out on this amazing experience. And now on to today's webinar, Your Questions Answered, More on Managing the Wig Process and Cosmetic Challenges. We're so pleased to announce again and have these amazing speakers. Amy Gibson, she is an alopecia hair loss expert and an international wig and accessory designer, author, alopecia spokesperson, and an Emmy-nominated soap opera actress. Kathleen Leonard, she's an Emmy-nominated celebrity, stylist, wigs and accessory designer, and educator. And last but not least, Georgia Van Kallenberg, she's a longtime NAF supporter, actress, TV host, filmmaker, and youth and human rights advocate. So now, please join us in meeting all of these three amazing speakers. Georgia?
Yes, let's do this. Okay. Folks, it is so good to be back with you and newly with you if you've joined, not coming for the first one. I want to just say right off the start of this, that we're going to move really fast through this because there are so many questions we have to answer. So I just want to like send you all a huge hug right now with the love and the kindness and the time and the effort, energy that we wish we could take for every single one of these questions and people that ask these questions, because obviously behind every question is a human being who needed help. And we just want to say that to you all, that we're maybe not going to take the time. We want to acknowledge you though, that this is not easy, that these questions were hard to ask. And we're going to do our best to just provide answers where we can and get right into it. So it is an absolute pleasure for me to be here with Amy and Kath doing this. I'm going to sort of be the question asker and my questions are over here. So it's not like I'm talking to somebody else every now and then. I promise I'm all about you, but my questions are over here. So I really want to say, of course, please come to NAF's conference. Please be there because this is where you get to be in community and talk about all this stuff. We obviously don't have the chat open today because it can just get a little wild in there otherwise, but that's a great opportunity, especially because Amy's gonna be there and she's gonna be able to help you in person. So if you haven't booked, I recommend doing that because I get the pleasure of seeing her in person and she's delicious. So the other thing to think about is our social media sort of presence. is helpful. All three of us are doing things on social media that are answering these questions. In particular, I just want to call out right away, because one of the questions in the last thing was, are there social media pages that talk through this stuff? One of the big ones, if I may so say so, for Amy is createdhair.com's YouTube channel. So if you...
Oh, George, I'm sorry. It's Created Hair by Amy Gibson for the YouTube. Oh, sorry. That's okay. Sorry. No, createdhair.com is the company, and createdhair.com. And, you know, we all kind of did a lot of the tutorials. So there's about 79 that we filmed last year. And then there's another 30 on there. So there's a lot to take you through it you may need if you can't get a hold of any of us or one of your stylists. Okay.
And look, there's lots of different accounts and videos, but of course, that's the one that we know. And we know we put a lot of heart and soul into making those. I mean, more so Amy and Kath and I just got to sometimes be the model, but they really put a lot of energy into that. So let's get into it, shall we? There were so many questions about where to find good wigs in the USA in particular. We didn't have too many, you know, international, but these questions online and things like that. So Amy, would you talk to us about some of the places that people can go and what you would recommend they do rather than just sort of giving it a go themselves?
Okay, so first of all, NAF is going to be putting this on the website. I discovered 12 really fun apps. So if you find a style online, say you go to wigs.com or Studio One Wigs, Wig Studio One, these people have just the most incredible, incredible amount of stock, especially, I mean, wigs.com and Wig Studio One have so much information, and also they're really great on the phone to kind of guide you with maybe right or wrong for you. But getting one of these apps, it allows you to actually take the piece you're thinking about or the style maybe that you have a picture that you've downloaded and put it on your own face, and then it saves you some time. We've had some questions though. So people wrote us from all over the place, from Kansas to New Jersey. I have a list of stores across the country. I can't publicize them, but if you write me at amy@createdhair.com, createdhair.com, and just say from the NAF in the subject matter of store location, please. I'll look up on my list, send me your zip code and some of the other zip codes in the area when you send me the email, and then I'll send you whatever stores are in that area. As for restocking fees for online, everybody has a restocking fee. I know that wigs are expensive, and we had a couple of comments about that. There's nothing you can do about a restocking fee. They're going to charge it. So that's why I try to be as perfect as possible as you can with at least what you think you want to wear. You can always Zoom with me for a few minutes, and I'll look and I'll go, maybe something longer or shorter. We also work with people all over the country. Probably 45% of the people that Kath and I work with, we never meet. We do everything by Zoom, send stuff out. But for you guys, if you want to shop online, just make sure the colors are correct when you're looking at the monitor. Everybody's monitor is different. Take your time. We're all emotional, right? When we're buying a wig, our heart's going, oh my God, that's so gorgeous. I want to see myself in that. Take a breath and really think about what you're buying, because if you have to return it, you're going to get less money back. Okay. So those are those two things on the stores.
Thanks, Ains. And I think something to keep in mind is a lot of these stores, there's people behind them, even if they're online, and you can always call and ask questions. And sometimes they'll even do video consults with you once you've sort of identified a wig that you're interested in. So keep that in mind. We had another question around that, Ains, about the white hair wig. So similar, like, did you want to address that?
So white is a much easier color in the last year to find. However, because it got popular, it also... they don't stock up a lot. They're kind of just entering the marketplace a little bit, all the manufacturers. So, you know, if they don't have it, go on back order, say, notify me if you don't. But I know that there are several, like John Renault has a great line of light platinums that they came out with. Wigs.com carries them. And so does Wig Studio One. They really work hard at trying to at least provide some very good synthetics that are comfortable and some really good also human hair. It's much easier to get those white colors in the synthetic hair. So sometimes what Kath will do is we're able to take a lighter platinum or lighter blonde and raise it to a platinum for you or for a white if it's not processed, if it's actually virgin hair, if it hasn't been colored already. But I think the best thing to do is sometimes call them and say, you know, are you going to be getting this color in? Because a lot of times if they get the calls and there's enough response, they'll tell the manufacturer and the next thing you know, they're going to be carrying more white. So those two websites is what I suggest. But you can always write me, tell me what your issue is, and then I'll search. I'll see who has a white wig for you, you know?
Okay, so a little bit of a random one in here. Can you wear a lace top wig if you have some hair, if you're looking at the different sorts of tops?
Well, that's interesting because if your hair's really kind of thin on top and you're wearing a lace wig over it and you put a little hairspray so you have your part showing down, the problem is if your hair is a different color, like if you have a lot of gray hair coming in and you're wearing a black lace top, it's going to show through, which is why I always say that silk tops are better for that. But if you can find one in your color and it just kind of blends, of course you can wear it with your own hair. You just got to, the color thing is the problem with lace top wigs.
And I will speak from experience for whoever asked that, the person that asked that question, I don't have their names written down, but I wear a lace front and this is my hair. So like, pulling all back this and putting the lace front in here, it still works. So
I think she said lace top though. Lace is the whole top. Lace front is great, but I think she was talking about, can you wear a whole lace top with your hair? And you can. And if your hair is the same color and you're going to have a part, I always say just pat down your hair, maybe a little hairspray or water, usually it's a little hairspray to make sure your part is nice and clean underneath.
Oh, that's matching.
Shows through the lace. Yeah, it shows through the lace wherever you're going to part that wig a little bit better.
Perfect. Thanks, Ames. Thanks for clarifying. Yay. So let's jump into, we had a lot of questions about getting sweaty. So obviously during summer with heat, with swimming, all that sort of stuff, what is a good wig to wear when you're swimming, when you're working out? How do you deal with the, and also this also applies to women who are hormonal. And get really warm.
Are you admitting that now? Okay. Okay. So actually there's a lot of suggestions in this area. So, you know, if you're just working out, you can always get a hat fall or a halo cap, which basically has no hair on top. And then from here down, there's hair. And you can always wear a really cute scarf with it. I wear it with a baseball hat. Okay. There are the if you're going to go swimming, I created the first women's swim wig with cyber hair. It's a company, they have the line now under private issue. It's a fabulous piece for swimming. I don't care where you are. If you can tape it down, that sucker is so amazing in the pool and working out. It's made to put it on, tape it on, shower, do what you got to do. And it dries very quickly in the same shape. There's also the water wig, which is all lace. So where cyber hair is a more fitted cap, water wig is a lace cap. But here's the deal. If you can't afford a higher end, because these are like $1,350 to $2,000, here's what I used to do when I had no money. I would take a synthetic piece. Okay, the water is still going to come in and out of a wefted piece. It's no great Einstein thing. But if it's a hand tie piece and it has no wefts in the back, sometimes it can bubble out with the water, so wefted pieces work better. I would tape that little sucker on. I would cut the nape in the back so it was shorter, which is what made me do the cyber hair design with a high back, because we don't need all that extra material if you're working out, right? And Georgia, you did the water wig video. You like dove in and everything. You were like my first one to test. I was like, oh God, please stay on. Okay, so that's, when I didn't have money, I just did it with a regular synthetic wig. Okay, here's the deal. If you only have a human hair wig or you have a couple and your other one is older and say you're stuck, you don't have your synthetic wig with you or whatever. Especially if it's blonde hair, for it not to turn green or blue in the ocean or chlorine, is take spray conditioner and just soak the hair. And what it does is it closes the hair and it won't sink in and take in any of that, because blondes can get that green kind of color, you know, and that usually stops that. So there you are about swimming. If you have enough funds, go with a better synthetic, like the cyber hair wig or a water wig. If you don't, definitely go for synthetic, and I can show you how to do it. We can have a little consult. And
someone asked about the tape. You can still use tape, because I used to when I wore that wig.
Right. But here's the deal. In any wig, this is polyurethane. And we sell it at Created Hair. It's super, super thin and it's translucent. It's the same color as your skin. I put it on the inside of my wig here and here and here and in the back. And that's where you put the little tape and that's where it will stay on, right? But you got to make sure that there's no hair there. And truly, if you have some hair back there and you don't need about this much, just cut a little bit so that the end of the wig will meet where there's no hair now and just put a little tape there. Oh, and there's one other wig to mention. Freedom vacuum wigs. I don't love vacuum personally. For me personally, it was hard for me to wear. It was hot. It was starting to itch. Sometimes it gets an odor from the perspiration. I like taking my wig off at night. I like washing my hair. I have clients who go back and forth between mine and a vacuum piece. So those are also good in the water. Just one more to mention.
Great. Thank you, Kath. Time for you, being sitting there looking so gorgeous. How does one find a wig stylist near Seattle for African American folks?
Okay, so the best way to find, I would do is go on Yelp. People are always talking about different hairstylists, especially in your area. They do have different websites that you can go on, that you can go look at. Let me see, there's one. But Yelp, you'll find that you can actually, they will tell you if you have someone's good or not. And it's just going to find out different locations. But let's see, if you go to Hair Necessities, they help you find different people and style seats. It's called the Book Wig Installer, and it's called Style Seats. And what they do is those are the people who install wigs, especially for African American. And so then that way you'll be able to call them, and you're going to have to do your research because it's all about wording to find that on Google. So my thing would be start with that, go to Yelp, and you're going to find that people are going to be talking about different salons. That's what we all do. And Instagram, they do have where a lot of stylists will post what they do in your area. And Instagram will actually take you to those locations of those people in your area. So that's the great way to find, so that you can actually see the work.
Perfect. Thank you, Kat. Mm-hmm. James, for somebody who wrote to us saying that they have a 24-inch head, so a lot of the stores don't have something that fits them. You know, they want to be open to different looks, but it's so limited. It's kind of like anything with clothing and shoes when you're a non-typical size. So what would you recommend?
Well, you want a wig then that's stretchy, right? So a lace, all lace wig is what I would suggest, because the mass market makes for size 22, not 23. So I agree with you, and I'm sorry you've had that hard time. One thing about, and Kath, you tell me if I'm wrong here, but I think an all lace wig would at least give to that 24 head, wouldn't you?
Yeah, but then if you need something not so expensive, just make sure that you get it where that you it goes through, because sometimes when they have the cap and they sew the wefts on, you're not going to get any movement. But the ones that are with the holes, they stretch too.
So the wefts sometimes can stretch. The hand tied that are made one, you know, like that, even in ready made, right? So I mean, Envy, I love Envy wigs. Envy hair is fabulous. They have a line that's also 20% human hair with 80% synthetic. And I'm telling you, that 20% human hair takes off that shine. But the cap that Alan made, who owns it, is so comfortable and it's so stretchy that that's something that would probably help you. But you try to go online and see who has a large first and then try to get a hand tied piece. That's what I would do.
Yeah. Perfect. Kath, while we're at it, could you text me the name of those websites so that I could, Gloria in the Q&A is asking for the names. If you text it to me while we're answering the next question, I'll write them.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you. Gloria, coming to you soon. And by the way, everyone else that's in the chat, I promise to do my best to get to you by the end because there's a few important questions in there. This one is close to my head and heart. At this time, my hair loss has a band of about 1.5, which is called an ophiasis pattern. For anyone that is presenting with hair loss that is around, like mine, that's called an ophiasis pattern. It's very normal in alopecia areata because the lymph nodes, the further you get away, this is how it all sort of, it's very normal. Unfortunately, it's the least responsive to a lot of the treatments. Me. But we have it and I have it and I feel you. So someone was asking suggestions. Amy had a few, and then I might jump in with just how I deal with it on a day-to-day.
Okay. Call me. I have a design that I've actually done. One for Georgia, actually. It's not something I put on the market right now. It's something I do individually for people who really need it. And so you can just write me at Amy at Created Hair, and I'll just make an appointment and we can do a Zoom, and I'll look at your hair and I'll see what we can do. Okay.
Great. I'm going to throw in just a few little ideas for me. I always wear headbands, but one of the things for our friend that asked that question, one of the tricks, because if you wear headbands and just push it back, people can see that you don't have sideburns, and it can look, people don't know what they're looking at, but they're like, something doesn't look quite right. So what I do is I put a headband, and then I allow this front piece to just kind of sit underneath like this with the headband there. And then I allow some of these hairs to just kind of poke out underneath, under here, so that it just gives this impression of hair there. And it's amazing how much better, especially because I have to be on camera a lot, how different that looks. The other thing that I've done quite a bit of, whether you want to do it, it's up to you, because if you're getting very sweaty, don't do it. But topic helps add a little bit more depth around the edges, around the front, can help me a lot. And then the other thing to do is a side part like this, so that you do get the body. Because if I did this in the middle, right, it's harder for me to show that I don't have that there. Whereas when I pull this, it gives the impression of more, and just letting that sit forward and constantly doing the sit forward.
That's great.
So there you go. That's my personal how I deal with this on a day to day.
The other thing you can do really is the old thing of the headband with hair. There are headbands with a little bit of hair around that also can be great. You can find online just to kind of get you through. That is a very difficult challenge, I have to tell you, because it's the frame, right? It's the frame. And Georgia, you have really worked with it off and on as you've lost the hair, brought it back. And I think it's the hardest thing. And African-American women have this a lot because of the pulling of the weave. And so they have a lot of alopecia in the front here. And it's a very common thing with women. So I hope
that's why I did create the halo too, because taking your, stop wearing wigs and gluing it on when you have edges, it just destroys it. And with you wanting fuller hair and just adding to your hair so you can give your hair a break, you can literally have a halo and it just comes forward. And this is made for African-American hair. It's our hair, but it gives you that weight and that heaviness in front without having to add glue and tape to it. And you can give your edges a rest. It's so important.
For those of people who don't know what a halo is, really quickly, Kath, can you explain?
Yes, well, let me see. Halo, I have them at different types, but for African-American, we always have a problem. We can't have curly hair sitting on the side because it doesn't help up here and it makes us look like a clown. I'm gonna take this off because I have one on. And you literally can take this and add it to your hair. And it will give you enough hair to go in the front so that you can have the right kind of weight so that you can have that where you're not trying to fill this in, but you can bring it forward and you're not having to, it's just like what she does. You just add that little extra in the front, but it gives you enough weight so that you can do it. And they're really easy. And I have them in different textures with curly texture, body wave, as well as texture straight.
But the main thing, but Kath, isn't the main thing, sorry, that it's big hair in 2 minutes and 2 seconds.
Big hair in 2 minutes, so 2 seconds.
The small is when you want a little bit of volume. The medium is when you want that. And the big is when you want some big hair.
Okay. Yeah, I like big hair.
Amazing. Quickly shifting to synthetic hair wigs.
Yes.
Would be the right place online that you would recommend, and brands that you've experienced to be better and long lasting?
Love Envy Wigs, like several of the John Renault, the Ellen Willies. I even like Jolie Chameleon sometimes. I like some of their stuff too, is very pretty. For a synthetic though, they do more human hair. For synthetic, I really like genre nose pieces in Envy Wig. You know, Amore has some pieces that are beautiful. They have a whole new line they came out with that I think is probably the best line they've had. Those are the main kind of ones that I like. Henry Margu. Henry Margu is a great line for synthetic. I think they definitely need a stylist for thinning. Okay, if you're gonna buy a Henry Margu wig, it needs a, just like any of these synthetics, watch the video that we have. Kathleen shows you how to take density out of a wig and put your baby hair in. It is vital. If you're gonna start on this journey, get the tools. And Kath teaches you everything from these videos. So those five I really like. For, again, Wig Studio One, wigs.com, they seem to be the biggest. Like they have the most choice for you. But one thing I love is their customer service. So you can get them on the line. And they really, I mean, I've been to their office. They have like 9 salespeople constantly on the line helping people with wigs. So that's what I like about them.
Amazing. And I want to add
in. I'd like to put in Beverly Johnson wigs for synthetic wigs for African-American as well. There's a lot of synthetic wigs that we have out there. So you can go on and you'll find.
What about Vivica Fox? What about Vivica
Fox? Fox has them. But just to let you know that, and Amazon sells some great, Amazon, we do on set, we'll go to Amazon and get some of our synthetic wigs to help us, you know, because they're easy to manipulate.
Love it.
Just keeping in mind always that there's a reason synthetic do not last the way that, like,
do not.
One of the biggest heartbreaks is people get these synthetic wigs and they don't last as long as they're hoping and they get hurt in their parts because of how good it looked when they first got it. So I just want to put that forward.
Cyber hair will last twice as long as any synthetic on the market, but they're limited style. Okay. Just keep that in mind. And you know, the main thing, of course, with synthetic, don't get near heat. Don't put your hair in the oven. Don't put your head in the oven like I did to go get the salmon. And like I pull out and my husband goes, what happened? But you know, they'll take you through. They'll take you through 9 months or 8 months or 6 months or maybe even a year, depending on the longer the piece, the more it's gonna tangle. Keep that in mind. Okay. With short synthetic pieces, those things can go much longer when they're shorter. But as you go longer, they tend to frizz, right? From our perspiration. Do not wear cologne here. If you're wearing wigs, don't wear it under here. It also causes frizz. So just be aware, do it here. Just don't spray it under the neck here where you're going to be wearing your wig.
I never knew that one. That's a new one for today. Cool. Kath, what are the pros and cons of 3D wigs? Are they available in the US?
Yes, they're definitely available. The good thing is that when you want to wear an updo, you can use like the got to be glue and just all the way around. The lace is very fine. It'll lay flat so that you can do an updo like for a wedding or for a prom or something. Now, the only thing is make sure you get the right color, because a lot of times you'll think, oh, 3D, and they come out way too white, or, you know, it depends on, just make sure that you look at the color, because if you get the wrong color, you're trying to dye it, and then that becomes a whole nother mess. I like to use makeup that helps, will hide all of that, but sometimes if you're sweating and stuff and the makeup rubs off, you might see that. So I would always say they work amazing. We do manipulate.
Can I ask what a 3D wig is? I don't even know.
Okay, so what you're doing, well, really it's just that it's all the way around. You're getting the lace all the way around here. And the lace is very fine so that you can be able to, it goes all the way up. You can go up, down, and then nobody will know.
Thank you. That just helps. I think there must be a couple of people in the thing were like, what is it? Is it like a, you have to wear glasses to look at it? I'm confused.
I'm gonna put my head back on.
Yeah, do it. While you're doing that, I'll turn to Amy again for a second. We have a person asking, it was great. Someone in the chat as well, Lisa asked this, but we had the question over here for petite heads, like mine and yours, Amy, but also smaller. Can you sew them and make them smaller? What are your recommendations? And this also might apply, maybe you can tell me if I'm wrong, but we have a mother, I think, in the chat asking on behalf of children. Okay. Is it a similar question?
Okay. I have an alteration department. You can always call me and we can take it in for you. But if you don't and you're at home, I took in my wefted pieces so easily. And actually, that is also a tutorial that we made with our alteration, is showing you how you actually can take in a wig. You know, there are little hooks in the back of a wig so that you can always take in. But when there's too much bagginess back here, if it's a wefted piece, you literally can remove two wefts and just sew them together, right? So you can remove two layers, and it's hard to do like this. So I suggest you go to Altering a Wig. I created her by Amy Gibson on YouTube, and literally Romero takes you through the whole alteration and how to do it. You can take it in with just a needle and thread. The main thing with taking in a wig is, if it's a lighter color wig, please use transparent nylon thread so it doesn't show. And if it's any other colors, just try to match it really perfectly, or you're gonna have a problem. It's gonna show through. But you can absolutely alter them. If you really are nervous about doing it yourself, just call me. And we have two people that do our alterations, and it's about a 2-week turnaround, and then they can come back to you.
Great. Have you heard of high definition hair for wigs in New York City?
You know, I haven't. That doesn't mean anything, because I don't know everybody in New York City. They could be very good. My apologies, but I don't know them.
That's okay. I just wanted to bring it up because it's here. I just bought a first human hair topper, but I can only get a solid color. Now, for those that haven't joined us before, toppers are pieces that sit, interestingly enough, on the top. And that they're not all the way around, but they cover for a lot of folks with androgenetic alopecia. They're very helpful, things like that. So she only got a solid color and is starting to gray. Where can I get a mixed color topper custom made?
Okay. Yes, we do them. And Kathleen's, one of her great specialties is all the silvers and grays. There's all kinds of grays, blues gray, muted gray. There's just so many colors. And this has been the biggest year, the last year and a half. We have done more gray, right, right, Kath?
Yes.
More gray, more silver, more streaky than I've ever done in 23 years of business. And I even got a gray hair piece that wigs.com gave me that rocks out. It's fabulous.
You look amazing in that piece.
It's like, cool, right? I like it. Bill didn't like it at all. Not at all. He was like, oh, you're following me, right? But the interesting thing about that is you're more apt to get the mixed color grays in a synthetic piece than in a human hair piece. However, if you're going to get it colored, say you're going to send it to Kath for coloring, make sure you get the highest color of the white that you can get, because then she can deposit the color. We can't bring it up to gray. You know, gray is a mixture of black and white, right? So we need to take it from a lighter color and start depositing color into it. And she does that all the time. Pardon me, but it's difficult. But there's more gray now. If you look at the places that I suggested, mm-hmm. see if wigs.com, call them, you know, call Studio One and ask them, you know, do you have, even if you can't find it on the site, because they also know what else they're doing, Wig Studio One as well. And they can.
Amy, do you want me to go to Kat for a second? Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Okay, because the next one is for you. Lace front wigs made me itch more. So
pardon me, they make me itch more. That is the problem with lace front. They itch when they start to fray. They itch like welded lace is a stiffer, harder lace. It's kind of sharp at the end. I'll tell you, if you end up getting that, there's a couple of things you can do. One, I take a little, you know, a nail file has two sides. One is the buffer side and one is the hard side. Take the buffer part, put the lace around your finger and just go like this and try to soften it up a little bit. There's also conditioning. What else do you use, Cap, to soften the lace? I'm going to put you on mute while I cough.
Fabric softener.
Really?
Fabric softener is great. Not only is it great for like lace, because it real soften it is fabric. And it's great to condition your synthetic pieces too. When your synthetic pieces are like kind of, it will calm them down. It's one way as the industry, we use fabric softeners to wash, to condition synthetic pieces as well.
So wait a minute. So you take a little bit of the softener. Oh, I'm sorry, George, you need a little bit of softener and then you put it at the end of the lace. You leave it on there or do you just wash
it? No, you can wash it. It's just like if you're washing, you can literally like, what I do when I'm washing a wig, sometimes like the inside, I wash the fabric, the thing, I will literally take it and put it, sit it in the fabric softener. It's not going to mess your hair up, but it just kind of softens the fabric. And you don't do it often, but just like for about 5 minutes, and then you can wash and condition the wig as normal.
I just want to put some time. When you say not often, what does that feel like to you, Kath? Just so people are clear.
Well, it's you won't have to do fabric softener every time. You'll probably do it maybe every 4 to 6 wash if you need to.
That's helpful.
Really, yeah. Get the stiffness out of that fabric because it has been, you know, it's new, it's stiff. They did all their work and all that. You just need to soften the fabric so it's not so tight on and everything is pricking you.
And then I think I need to jump in here. Let's just do it now. Considering I was the experience.
Okay.
So he now has an answer for this because of years and years of dealing with it. So I will not let her go without talking about it.
So it took me 6 years to bring scalp cushion to market. And scalp cushion is, I might as well just show you. I have my tape on, so it's kind of hard. But you see, I'm wearing it. It's actually my wig caught onto it, darn it. I have tape on here. That's scalp cushion.
You so beautiful. Scalp cushion,
I love you, girl. Thank you. So what it does, it actually is a buffer for the irritation that you can sometimes get in from the hair poking in wigs and toppers. And what's good about it is once I already put this one I put on about an hour ago, and you see that it already conformed to my head. It's made with medical grade silicone. It is hyperallergenic. It's super light, but it gives that extra couple of layers in there, and it's breathable material. And now with the lace front and the itchy thing, you know, last week I was going to that thing, Kath, and I actually took the scalp cushion because one of my wigs had this lace that was driving me crazy. And I brought the scalp cushion forward just under the lace, just like, and it was translucent. Like I've never done that before, even with it, but I needed to do something because the lace was driving me crazy. So scalp cushion, it's for retail, it's for wholesale. It's on my site now, createdhair.com. It'll be on Amazon in another day. And you know, it took me 6 years, right? Because two factories couldn't do it correctly. And it's a huge problem is the itchiness. Now it's not a wig cap. So let's discuss that for a moment. There are times you'll actually need a full wig cap, okay? Either for your own hair or sometimes a full wig cap, you know, gives you that extra because I get itchy back here, right? I get itchy back down below with my wigs sometimes. So, you know, that will help, you know, just with a wig cap will help with that. But that's scalp cushion. And to keep a wig on, you know, there are a lot of wig bands out there. This one has been out for a bit. I came out with Wig Secure, and it has a piece of silicone grip strip, and it's also curved to fit the head correctly. And this is the only medically approved band on the market. And it's reversible. It's made for people with and without hair. So that I also worked on for many, many
years. Can I add something to that? What I do like about with the wig band is because we get a lot of traction alopecia from the clips. And with that, we'll secure your wig so that you don't have to clip it and irritate the scalp and lose hair. That's what I love about it. And with the scalp cushion is amazing because most people who put on wigs for fashion, they got hair, they're not gonna feel it. But we're talking about people who have thin hair, no hair, who really need that buffer and protection. It's amazing.
Thank you. Worked hard on it. I hope it helps a lot of people.
I think that's something to really call out because obviously like Ames is and Kath are doing this just to help the community, but it really like nothing, there's no anything. It's just, we're talking about the things that have worked for us, but I know that all of the things they've created come from the experience of every day dealing with the issues. So I just want to call that out right away and how incredible they are. I think within the scalp cushion conversation last time, we had a lot of questions. So now it is available. It is available on the website. Right. And that was a lot of the questioning. And one of the questions was also around women with different skin colors.
Oh, right.
this current one, we had a model on the commercial that is African-American, and she could wear it without a problem. So I don't want to speak directly to it, but I wanted to call that out because that was repeated many times in the chat last time.
And you can always put makeup on it. You can always dab a little bit of your foundation and it will just totally make it the skin color. So there's ways to get around that.
Yeah, at the end of the year, we'll be looking at, we have prototypes.
Yes.
I just haven't chosen the right color yet. But there's a whole bunch, I mean, I'm making them, they're coming out smaller for toupees. They're offered in 5x6 right now. I have bigger ones coming out. I have a whole line of these coming out. So thank you for shouting out to that. I wanted to remember though, you guys to remember that you're not stuck, right? You're not stuck. And you know, for years, I didn't have any money to, there was nothing on the market to help me with a wig band. And so I finally created one, but there was nothing that I could find that really kept me from perspiring so much or that itchiness. And I would put like cotton in there and t-shirts and cut them up. And, you know, it really has taken a long time. I am curious to your thoughts. There's also an extra cushy that'll be coming out as well, which is a 3-layer. But the 2-layer really is sufficient to help you. Itchiness is a really hard thing.
Yeah. On that note, and then I want to throw in one for the fellas, but quickly, Kath, we've got questions around aloe vera, tea tree oil, burdock root. What else is good for sensitive scalps?
Olive oil. Olive oil is going to be your best oil because it's very organic. It's natural. You can get the extra light if you want a very thin layer, if you just need that little heaviness. Olive oil is best. And you'll, even dermatologists will tell you that it's one of the best for your skin without having an allergic reaction.
Amazing.
There's one more thing though, George. There's a company called Lemieux, L-E-M-I-E-U-X. I carry them. They've been out for a long time. They were created by 3 oncologists who didn't have, there was nothing available for either their family member or friend that was going through radiation and chemo. They have an incredible product called Soothing Balm. Mm-hmm. That is truly a the balm for cooling the scalp down if it's burning. So Lemieux, that one product I just love of theirs, Lemieux Soothing Balm.
Amazing. So I'm going to quickly, I don't want to run out of time here. And we've got a couple of important questions in the chat I want to get to. So let's do a quick on tape. Ames, your turn is what are the best tapes, especially waterproof. And then Kath, could you talk quickly about how to remove them in the best way? So you go first, Ames.
Okay. So first of all, there was a really important question because there are a lot of people that are allergic to latex. So there are 3 really good ones that you can buy that are wig tape. One is made by, 2 are made by Vapon. Vapon Top Stick is totally latex free, okay? And we use that with men's and women's pieces. And then they have a Vapon Lace FX for lace pieces that's also hypoallergenic like the other one. And the last one is called, now this one I haven't used, okay? But it's called Lori Lane Waterproof Lace Glue. It's latex free and oil resistant. I don't use it, never have, but it had a lot of interesting comments about it. So those are the 3. Now with tape, we carry something called the water wig tape, which is literally something you can work out in. You put it on, once it hits your body temperature, it just kind of bonds and stays on. If you start moving the wig though, I didn't put on straight, you lift it 2 or 3 times, you're gonna take that tape off and do it again. But that's a very strong tape. And you know, it's so strong that you could actually, you need to be very careful in taking the tape off, which Kath is gonna explain to you in a second. I think Top Stick is a great all-around tape. There is the blue tape that has the little holes on Amazon, also very good. Kath, do you know any other tape ones that you love? Type of tape?
Well, I like the blue tape. I like the extra hold blue tape.
Yeah.
They do have, I like the ones with the holes in it so that it's more breathable. So that way, if you're sweating, it has some way to release and it's just not, the tape can hold without it just not being wet underneath it. It helps.
That's so, Kath, how do you get your tape off the wigs?
Amazon. Because of,
sorry, just to interrupt. I mean, removing the tape, what products?
Okay. So 99% alcohol, not 70, 1 or 7% and not 91. 91 is not going to really break it down. You really need 99% alcohol. And then there is companies who make lace remover. I love Bold Hold. They have a lace remover that will break it down, as well as Kiss. Kiss has one that will literally break it down and lather up. Now, the problem with a lot of times with the glue, it gets gummy and sticky and like an oil. After you remove this, like a lot of times I will take with 99% alcohol, I will put it on a mirror and then just rub the lace in the front, rub it right on the mirror. What happens is the alcohol in the mirror will literally just start taking the glue off the lace. Now that's one way of doing it. So another way is I would—
Hold on, Kat. Hold on. So you're going to take it. I just want to, so you have the piece. Yes. And then, okay.
So you'll put, like, you'll have the mirror flat, put a little alcohol on the mirror and literally just, you'll literally take the lace on the thing and then just rub it on there gently, and you'll start seeing it stick to the mirror.
That's great.
Yes, that's the original way we do it. So that way it removes it without you're like trying to figure out. You won't mess up the hair or the lace connection. Because if you do it with a brush or stuff, it frizzes and it frays the hair and it makes it pull through the lace. This way you can do it. And if it feels like it's sticky or something, Dawn liquid soap is the best to remove that oil and that stickiness from the lace. I do it all the time with those. Those are very important.
I want to add one last thing, even though it's not on here. Mm-hmm. Taking down shine on a wig is really a common thing, especially with lighter colors. Mm-hmm. What's it called? The drying sheets that you put in the dryer?
The fabric sheets.
You just wipe it. It's amazing. It takes off all the shine. Yes. I meant to mention that last time.
Oh, yeah, that takes the shine off of the synthetic hair too. Is what when I say do the fabric softener, it takes the shine off the synthetic wigs.
Okay, cool.
Okay, yeah. One for the fellas. Where can they find wigs with sideburns?
I mean, his and hers.
Yeah.
Or you got to get a custom. A lot of the stuff that we do on sets, all of that is custom pieces. None of that is where you just go buy, you know, like Nigel's. You have to go to a beauty supply store that actually deals with television and theater, because those are the ones that will have that. That's their world.
Perfect. Thank you, Kat. Ames, we had a question about wearing glasses and wigs and hearing aids and wigs.
Perfect. So, you know, every wig has a side, right? It's a side of a wig. And what I find is if you just fold this, sometimes I don't really want to say cut it because then you're going to lose the sideburn. But if you fold this piece up a little bit, or if you raise the wig up just a little bit and then tape it, like I have glasses now and I had to lift this wig when I put it back on, I had to lift it a little bit to make room for the glasses. Hearing aids are an issue with the wig if you're wearing a mask. If you're not wearing the mask and you have the hearing aid, a lot of times I will fold down that little ear piece, or I'll cut a little bit just to make a little room. But really folding this allows you to kind of have a little bit more room for your stuff. I hope that was clear. It's kind of hard without doing it on Zoom with somebody, you know.
And that's something that obviously, there's a lot of these questions that are very personal. So remember, Amy did give her email she's so kindly offered to do quick chats with folks that need some more help. So just that email again, just in case people joined.
Amy@createdhair.com, createdhair.com. And Kath, they can just call me, Kath, and then they can get to you, or they want to give your website.
You can always reach me. I do have a website, KathleenSecret.com, or my email is KathleenSecretsSalon@gmail.com.
Perfect. I'm going to do a couple of really quick ones, if we can do this really quickly, because I don't want to miss out on a couple that I've seen come through. So if a part's being set in one side and someone wants to move the part, I'm guessing all wigs are not made equal in that regard.
No.
So
designs are caps. They will, especially stock pieces. If you have a permanent part, you'll see that underneath, if you look, the cap is made for only that part to be actually parted there with a lace here. Like these are stock mostly that are, you know, you buy off the thing. And then they'll have wefts up in here. Unless it's a full front lace, it's that's the part. Now on camera, when I'm working the movies, a lot of people don't know. Sometimes we'll take that wig and we'll adjust it and we just fold them ear pieces up. And you think that part is made for the middle. So sometimes you gotta cheat it.
But don't you sometimes steam it over, Kath?
Yeah, but that's if it's lace, like I can move it over. Yes, but if they have it where it's just that lace right there on the left side and you have all these wefts underneath on the right side, just shift your wig and then put that part right there. And you will not believe, nobody will ever even know what's going on. But otherwise, check the cap. That's going to let you know if you can move from left to right. The cap is very important. That's why Amy is very important when it comes to wig makers, wig designers, because they understand what you're going to want, because you're not going to think about it until after you get the wigs. But with Amy, who has been through this so many times, they've already been through it and thought about it for you.
Okay, so I'm going to throw one more at you, Kath. Otherwise, we're going to run out of time completely. Disguising the front with lace front. I would love to know this because I sometimes mess it up. How do you disguise the lace in the front?
Okay, so if you wanted to lay flat, you are going to have to use a product like, hold on one second. Let me get girlfriend right here. With the lace, because like you see, she has lace. This is all lace and it's movable. Like you'll find that it'll move easy. And I find that a lot of times when you just put it on there, it doesn't fit. This is mostly stock pieces. It doesn't fit on your head, right? I will take some of my got to be glue hairspray and just right there on the edge. Even if you use your hair, you can put it right there in between your hair and just spray a little bit. Just get that right there and let it dry where it's tacky. You want to make sure it's tacky so that, and it doesn't have to be all the way around. Like, and this doesn't have to be a whole lot, just very little, tap, tap, tap. You can take a comb and go in between here and then tap, tap, tap and let that dry. And it will stay mostly the whole day. Do not have makeup product or moisturizer on your hair because that will get in the way. But this way, you don't have to worry about it moving. And then the hair looks like it's coming from your scalp.
Amazing.
And that's the easiest way. Even my men do it for their toupees. I have told them how to do it because the glue is too much for them. Like, you know, men just, yeah, it's too much work.
George, real quick, because I know we're running out of time, but while we have Kath right here with that wig, Kath, getting rid of frizzies, getting rid of the flyaways.
So fabric toughener is good for that. But let me tell you something, for synthetic hair, steaming it will help a lot. Taking a blow dryer and just kind of just smoothing it down helps on a very low, not high hard, because then you can recreate it. But there's a little trick I do with human hair. What I do is I take 2 drops of oil drops, because a lot of times you're trying to control it, it doesn't work. And you put hairspray, that messes up everything. I mean, water, that's not gonna work, bro. A little bit of hairspray together. What's going to make it not stiff and not sticky, but it's going to lay that hair down good. It's going to be nice and not too shiny, but just enough shine and enough hold. What happens is the hairspray makes the oil drops not too oily, and it stops the oil stops the hairspray from drying your hair out from the alcohol. So it's a counter. But it works amazing.
Didn't you do the video? Didn't we do one that says take it? We did steam out the frizz.
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's for synthetic hair. I'm just doing for the human hair too.
Okay, so I want to.
Can I add you one thing with the synthetic?
Do it.
When it gets really matted and stuff under there, what I do take is I will spray it with water and a very low curling iron or flat iron, like 200, no more than that. And I'll comb it and I'll just, and it will steam. You'll hear like, but when you do it, it smooths it out all the way to the end so that you can wear your hair longer, especially from back there. That's how I smooth out all the synthetics so that my client's synthetic piece lasts twice as long.
Okay, amazing.
That was great.
Quickly, we've had a lot of people ask about brows and lashes. And within this, we were really aware that there was just no way that we could cover it in the depth we were needed. I'm going to jump in with two answers and then maybe we'll like do a blast on that really quickly. Insurance. A lot of people are asking, and they asked last time as well, right now. So, you know, there's a couple of insurance providers that do acknowledge that hair prosthesis or wigs are coverable. There's only a few. Right now, there is a bill or a measure, one of those two, going to the Senate that is going to change that. If we all vote for it, well, if the Senate votes for it and we tell our senators to vote for it, that will acknowledge that prosthesis and hair, wigs and everything are a medical need. That, and so please reach out to NAF if you want to be part of that conversation, if you want to help. I'm doing it, I've just started, because the only way that we can change that is to have different senators sign us as co-sponsors and all that sort of thing. So for those that are asking, yes, there are some insurance, call your insurance and find out. Do not spend the money and just think you can send in the receipt. Make sure that your insurance, believe me, the things I've been through with my insurance, I hate to think what this would be like. So please check first and then be part of the conversation with us, because it's in there. It's on the docket. They're going to change it. It's huge because we've got an allocation in the Senate. These things are changing. So let's all work together on doing that. And we can answer your questions directly. The other thing for Linda, who has donor hair for her 10-year-old daughter, quickly, Amy, I mean, I know Hair We Share in New York does wigs for little young people. Who would you recommend that she talks to make a wig for her daughter?
Well, we make them for kids, so it's fine. And if I can't, then I'll turn around to somebody who can. Yeah. Right, if it's something I can't do. It's important. I want to mention something really quick before we go off of here. There's, you know, different techniques that are being done for microblading and brows. And of course, we know microblading, we know tattooing. Well, there's something now called a fluffy stroke, which I don't know. Have you ever heard of this, Kath? I mean, George? Mm-hmm. So there's a place, because I've been researching, we had so many questions about where can we get tattooed. Golden Brows is a place in Beverly Hills. I'll actually give you $100 off if you have alopecia and you say that you saw the NAF webinar. You got to look at this place's website. I'm going to be honest, I haven't gone to them yet, but they're the person that I'm going to choose to take off the mistake that someone made years ago and do my brows. So I'm no longer going to use pencils. I love using pencils because they're different styles all the time, but I think I'm ready to get like a permanent thing. And I really like them. And for lashes, we can go over that another time. You can always write me, you can do a quick Zoom with me and I'll show you. There was a woman that asked something really important about an Afro wig. And if you don't mind me just addressing that real quick, Kath, I mean, George.
I mean, it's 69.
She said she had a spot in her hair, you know, and in her head. And I would, and she has Afro hair. And I said to Kath this morning, we can always make those. It's not a problem. You know, they do have those little fillers that are out, but not really for African-American hair. And you can go get a cheap Afro wig, just cut a little hole like this, a circle. Get some polyurethane. If you don't have any, call me and I'll send you, you know, it's not that expensive. And you literally sew it to the back and then you're going to be able to tape it on and just blend right into your hair. I just want to say that because I really felt for her and we didn't address her question from
last time. And we do have, like, even if it's like a thin spot right there, it's a hair comb and it's—
Right.
Yeah, but it's a comb, you can just put it right into the hair. So you can make that one spot fuller so that you're in control of where you want to do it.
So ladies and gentlemen and folks and people, it's 5:00 and we could have kept going again for another hour from the questions we've now got and that we didn't get to answer. Like I said to you, this doesn't feel complete. It feels like we need to all have like a little sing along and hug now because we've all been vulnerable and honest about stuff that's challenging us, but we just don't have the time. So please, I think the most important thing is you can reach out to us. I'm on Instagram, Georgia Van C, or Facebook. I will help if I can. My stories are just through learning from Ames and Kath and my personal experience. But Amy with her email is the best place to go. We don't want you to go through this alone. That's the magic of NAF. That's what NAF creates, is this safe community. So on that note, thank you. But I'm going to hand it back to Judy at NAF to give you all the like final things. And we adore you all. And thank you for being part of it.
Thanks, George.
And Judy, are you going to talk? Or
we can't hear you, girlfriend.
Thank you. Thank you, Amy, Georgia, and Kathleen, for this amazing information. We see all the hearts, the thumbs up. This is amazing information. We did get a lot more questions. But like we mentioned, Amy will be at our conference in Denver. So please make sure you go in and register so you can see her in person and ask as many questions as you'd like. We want you to share, please share your feedback on this webinar. You will see the link provided right after the end of this webinar. Thank you to the audience as well for joining us today and submitting your questions. Make sure you give us your feedback, and we do appreciate you attending this webinar.
Thank you, guys.
And of course, join us for next webinar, Turning Alopecia Areata Advocacy into Action, taking place on Tuesday, June 13th. What does it mean to be an advocate for alopecia areata? Join this webinar to hear from members of the alopecia areata community who have taken their advocacy to the next level, just like Georgia mentioned. Dermatologist Kristen Losico, along with founding members of the Alopecia Justice League and NAF legislative advocates, Allison, Julie, and Lindsay, they'll talk about advocacy work, key issues for the community, and the personal empowerment that comes from making a difference. Great. And before we end our webinar today, another plug for our conference. I want to give you a glimpse of some of our speakers at this year's annual conference. In addition to community and empowerment sessions hosted by speakers like Amy, we will also have various research presentations from medical professionals such as Dr. Brett King and Dr. Brittany Craiglow, among many others. And there is still time to register. And if you register before June 13th, you can get our early bird registration fee. Use the link or this QR code on your screen. And NAF offers a number of resources and programs to the alopecia areata community, including support groups, our youth mentor and legislative liaison programs, as well as news and webinar links and how to get involved. To learn more about NAF and the resources we offer, please visit naf.org or email us at support@naf.org. Thank you. And this concludes today's webinar program. Thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you on the next webinar.
Bye, guys. See you there.
Bye.
Thanks, NAF.